Imagine you live in a society where one day, while you are safely and reasonably driving your new car down the street, you are pulled over and arrested solely because the arresting police officer doesn't like the color of your car. The police officer puts you in the jail for 5 years. 5 years later, after being released from the jail, you painted your car another color and then pulled over arrested again because a different police officer doesn't like the new color of your car. This is unfair. The police can't arrest you because he doesn't like the color of your car. The society in this case above is called autocracy. People think autocracy is brutal and it needs to be changed. Therefore, we come up with a new concept, the rule of law. As the world society gets bigger, the importance of the rule of law has become more critical than ever before. The rule of law offers the citizens of the country a stable, predictable, and ordered society, which is fundamental and essential for a healthy country. So, what is the rule of law? Let's take Canada as an example. Based on the constitutional law of Canada, the rule of law is a principle of long-standing constitutional value. It is recognized in the preamble of the Constitution Act, 1982, and has been utilized by the courts as important constitutional rhetoric, and also a doctrine that produced juridical effects in various contexts. Also, according to United Nations Security Council in 2004, the rule of law is a principle of governance in which all persons, institutions, and entities, public and private things, are accountable to laws that are publicly promulgated, equally enforced, and independently adjudicated. All of us can be affected by the rule of law. For example, police are supposed to give a ticket to all people that make mistakes equally, not based on the person's social status or wealthiness or the color of their cars. Actually, the rule of law is imaginary, which means it is hard to define the exact definition. Justice Jack Watson from the Court of Appeal of Alberta thinks that the rule of law is a thing which is around us all the time. It is sort of in the air that we breathe. It is the ultimate protection for everything we are and what we do. Even if it is not visible and its importance is hard to define, it is obviously super important to maintain our society. The former president of the United States, Ronald Reagan, once said, "Freedom prospers when religion is vibrant and the rule of law under God is acknowledged." Also, another former president of the United States, Dwight Eisenhower, said, "The clearest way to show what the rule of law means to us in everyday life is to record what has happened when there is no rule of law." The rule of law is like air. Its importance is not known until it is lost. There are lots of ways for the rule of law to impact our life. One example can be a lone motorist at the deserted intersection in the middle of the night who waits patiently for the red light to turn green, despite there not being anyone around. This example shows the deep-seated respect that most people have an idea for the rule of law, both in theory and in practice, and shows their understanding of the value system and acquiescence to being part of the social contract that binds us all. For a more accurate and specific answer, we briefly interviewed Eric's family lawyer, Ms. Chang, from Kim & Chang Law Firm Company about the importance of rule of law and how it affects us.
Hi. Here is my lawyer, Ms. Zhang, and she is here for interview today.
안녕하세요.
안녕하세요. 먼저 rule of law라는 질문에 대해 여쭙겠는데요. 이것이 왜 중요한지 설명을 해주시면 감사하겠습니다.
Rule of law는 한국말로 법치, 법에 의한 통치입니다. 누구나 법 앞에서는 평등하다는 것이 핵심인데요. 법의 의가 통치를 하면 인간의 감정에 치우치지 않고 정확하고 효율적인 기준이 생기게 됩니다. 이로써 rule of law는 법의 기본이며 시민들의 재산 권리를 지켜주기도 하는 중요한 원칙입니다.
그러면 이제 이 rule of law가 왜 중요한지 설명을 해 주실 수 있으신가요?
법에 의한 통치는 매우 중요합니다. 예를 들어, 인간 삶의 기본인 인권조차 법에 의한 통치를 받기에 한국에서는 항상 인권 존중을 받고 살고 있는 것입니다. 인권에 대한 법의 통치가 없다면, 현재 코로나 상황에서 환자들은 총살을 당할 수도 있고, 일방적으로 폭행을 당해도 아무런 법의 구제를 받을 수 없을 것이고요. 또 아동들은 많은 위험에 처하게 될 수도 있습니다. 때로는 비합리적인 법도 있지만, 우리가 행복하게 살수 있는 그 자체가 법에 의한 통치를 받기 때문이라고 쉽게 설명할 수 있겠습니다.
그렇군요. 감사합니다.
네, 감사합니다.
The rule of law is very important for normal society, but in some parts of the world, it's under threat. For example, many things now show that rule of law in North Korea has been threatened. Chapter 1, Article 4 of the Constitution of North Korea states, "The sovereignty of the DPRK resides in the workers, peasants, soldiers, working intellectuals, and all other working people." However, based on the research report by the BBC, the state controls everything and actively spies on its citizens using a vast surveillance and informal network. Also, in Chapter 5, Article 68 of the Constitution of North Korea states, "Citizens have freedom of religious belief. This right is granted through the approval of the construction of religious buildings and the holding of religious ceremonies." However, in the report by the BBC, Arnold Fang, a researcher from Amnesty International, tells BBC that, in reality, there is no freedom of religion. Everyone is indoctrinated to treat the Kim family almost as something to worship. In conclusion, the rule of law in North Korea is seriously threatened. Even though the rule of law has been enshrined in the constitution, but the state does not follow the constitution and no other government agency urges it to do so. The good news is, in an article by Daily NK published in November 2019, former North Korean diplomat Tae Yong-ho calls on North Korea to shift towards a political system based on the rule of law rather than the rule by one man, Kim Jong-un. Let's hope North Korea will change one day in the future and build a society with the full rule of law. So, this is the basic idea of the rule of law. The rule of law is a principle of justice stating that the law is necessary to regular society, that law applies equally to everyone, and that people are not governed by arbitrary power. The rule of law is essential for a healthy society, and it affects every one of us deeply. Although the rule of law is being challenged in some parts of the world, we hope that one day all the people in the world will embrace the rule of law. And that must be a better world. Thanks for watching.